are very low. Out of 1,000 hatchlings that made it out of the sand, only one will survive out of 1,000. Majority of the time when they begin to dig their way out of the sandy grave, the first three on top are doing all the digging for a little back. Obviously, they cannot move with the whole thing. They will kill her, take whatever meat they can, and leave the rest there to rotten. You cannot touch her anymore. She is out of a chance. The reason why I can tell is because she has started to cover back the egg chamber. Now, leatherback will dig the egg chamber until the back flippers cannot pick up any more sand. At the bottom of the egg chamber, she will dig it wrong, like a football. That is called a chamber. The chamber is held to store heat to help incubate the eggs. Now, she could be approximately 700 to 800 pounds. Every time she puts sand on top of her eggs, she will compact it with her body weight. The reason why she will compact it so gently is she are binding the sand together, so if the rain were to fall, the water will take long to penetrate to get to her egg.
It takes forever for the boat to stop rocking to get off the horizon, and it's like, you know, you go lining up the stanchions at the horizon.
Coming deeper, coming deeper.
I took a ship from England to South Africa one time.
Okay,
Did you guys ever have a system of grabbing up eggs that have been dug up and then reburying them and stuff?
As I mentioned, once the embryo is formed.
Oh,
again, after the next